Hey everyone, today we're gonna learn how to send over our first custom XAPI statement inside a Storyline and even explore what comes out of the box. Now I have a lot of XAPI and Storyline videos you can check out here, how to get started, even the basics and the breakdown of what XAPI is. Go ahead and check out those videos and it will tell you a lot of information there. Today we're just gonna focus on how do I work with or start with Storyline and XAPI, just the basics kind of getting out of the box with some custom Storyline and some custom XAPI statements. My name is Jeff Batt, and if you haven't checked out my website, go ahead and head on over to learningdojo.ninja. You can check out all my previous blog posts. You can also download free templates with XAPI and Storyline, and then check out full courses and all these learning development tools as well. All right, so XAPI allows us to get more detail for some learning experiences that happen. And really what I'm talking about is things that will happen to the learner or what the learner does inside of these digital learning experiences. Now, most of the time, the digital learning experience will be something like a course, but you're not like Storyline or Captivate Alert or Lectora, but you're not restricted to just these tools. You can actually track any type of digital learning experience. If it has some type of digital touch point, you can track that as well. But I'm specifically just going to show you how to do this within Storyline. And if you think about SCORM and traditionally what we can get out of SCORM, it really is just a matter of starting in progress, quiz data, and then completion, which in a lot of ways you can get more details out of that in SCORM, and you could do a lot with SCORM, but it's not as simple as what or the specific details you can get with XAPI. Now, with XAPI, you can track who the person is, what action did they do, and that is a key word there because what you want to do is tie these different statements to the actions that are happening inside of the course. We'll come back to that. And then what is the object? What did they actually do? So in this case, it could be Jeff Batt clicked on or clicked on tab one, so the description of what the action is. So let's go in and explore just out of the box. If I were to publish inside a Storyline, let me come to page number one here, and I was to go into my home tab and click on publish. If I were to publish just to XAPI and CMI5 or either one, and publish that and upload it to my LMS, if my LMS can handle CMI5 or it can handle XAPI, you can get this data from your LMS already. Now, what kind of data can you get? I'm gonna go into SCORM Cloud, which is a test LMS that I use, and it's kind of the standard LMS. If it works in SCORM Cloud, it should work in your LMS. But if you click on View Registration History, this is a course that I've already taken. Notice what Storyline is doing already. So Storyline will track as soon as the course launches that they've launched it, that it's initialized, and that they've attempted it. So these are different verbs, and it will give you the course name as well. And then on top of that, they track that the learner has experienced it as soon as they go to a page, and then that they left the page as well. So a lot of information. You could start tracking what pages have they visited, what pages have they not visited as well, based on what comes out of the box. And then if we come up to the top here, if you have quiz questions, it'll say either correctly answered and then what the question was, or incorrectly answered and what the question was as well. And if they, and it could be if it's like multiple choice, which one they answered with and so forth. So it gives us kind of that standard information and that quiz data still, but it will also let me know when I terminated it. So in this case, I terminated, meaning that I closed the course on this question. So I could see like, why did they exit at this point? But also on this experienced and left, there is a lot of information that's kind of metadata. If you come in here and click on that, notice this one right here, duration. Duration will tell me how long they spent on the page. This lets me know how much time this person has actually spent on the page. And that will essentially mean that are they spending just a couple of seconds? Have they spent 10 seconds or a minute? Are they consuming this for a longer time than I expected? This gives us a lot of information on just the duration. Now, I could even come down here and add on additional descriptions. I can add on additional information to this. I can grab like detect the time. I could pass that information. There's a lot that you can do with XAPI, but this is really really what comes out of the box with Storyline. Now, on top of that, this is where we can start adding some information. But before I go there, I want to actually go to Veracity here. There's a lot of different learning record stores where it captures this XAPI data. But Veracity, even if you have an LMS that only allows SCORM, you can still get XAPI data and use something like Veracity, or even go back to SCORM Cloud, you can use something like SCORM Cloud. But the nice thing about Veracity is it allows us to create custom reports based off of this data. So if I go into this one, for example, and then I'm gonna go into my analytics, and then I come into my custom dashboard and go into Cooking 101 here, these are all custom dashboards and widgets that I've created. If you want to see how I've created these widgets inside of Veracity, go ahead and go to my YouTube channel and comment down below and say, hey, I want videos on how you created these custom reports. I'm happy to provide those. I just want to see if anyone's interested. So head on over to my YouTube channel and comment on my YouTube channel if you're interested in that. But down here, notice this average per slide. So I can see average time per slide. How much time did the learner spend on that page? And I can get an average what time or what page people are spending most of their time on. You could even do it per course, average course duration, and I can get that information, or average score or score per user. You can kind of drill down to all of that inside of Veracity. So SCORM Cloud will just give you that feed, but Veracity or Watershed or whatever tool that you may be using allows you to get more granular, shareable types of dashboards. That is the learning record store where all the information comes in. All right, so now let's get to the custom, being able to send over custom XAPI statements. So let's go ahead and go back into our course here. And really, it's a matter of where you want to send these different events. And this is where I start to put on my detective's hat, where I'm like, okay, what types of experiences is the learner doing? Are they watching a video? Well, if they're watching a video, what information do I want to know about that video? Do I want to know if they've completed the video? Do I want to know if they paused the video? Do I want to know if they reached halfway in the video? Do I want to know if they clicked on tab 1 or tab 2 or tab 3? What information do I want to know? Yes, you can track pretty much everything. So it just comes down to your instructional design strategy, figuring out what do you want to know, and then adding the different triggers to those events. Events are essentially what happens during the course. So I'm going to go to one of my experiences here, and this is a tab interaction. So if I click on this here, what I want to know is if they've actually clicked on tab 1. Did they actually experience it? Did they interact with it? And so what I'm going to do is go into my tab 1 layer, and I could do this actually when they click on the tab, but I want to make sure that they've gone to tab 1. And I can add this when they've finished the timeline. I can do this as soon as the timeline starts. And I'm just going to do it when the timeline starts. So I'm going to add a trigger, and then I'm going to select this drop-down box and go ahead and let's do send XAPI statement. So we already know that some XAPI statements are coming out of the box with Storyline. This is in addition to those statements. So I'm going to go ahead and select this drop-down box and do pick a verb that pretty much matches what I want. And this would be like interacted, I think works well. Now there's only like 12 verbs there. I don't know why Storyline didn't implement all the different verbs. If you want to see what other verbs you can actually use, head on over to this great resource, and I'll paste a link in the description. But if you go to xapi or tools.xapi.ly, this will allow you to search through all the different verbs that are available. If you select this drop-down box and click on verb, and then you go through and you can see that all of these different types of verbs are things that you can use. And I do have a video on how to specifically change out the verb. I'm not going to cover that in this video, but you can pretty much use any verb inside of Storyline. So let's go back here. And what do I want to say interacted with? Well, I could do this based on the slide name and just grab the slide name, or I can do this based on the object. So the object would be whatever the text is inside of that tab, which I called it tab 1. You probably would call it experience 1 or whatever the title is, and they click on that. So you could just grab that title, or you could come into custom and click on custom text. And so I can just type in whatever I want at that point and hit enter. If for some reason I want to edit or add on to this XAPI statement, I can click on this plus XAPI and it takes me right into the JSON file. If you want to learn more about XAPI and how to manipulate and adjust this XAPI content, I have a full course on XAPI and I talk specifically about this. But let's go ahead and just leave it as is. So I'm gonna hit cancel and then I'm gonna just have this happens when the timeline starts and click okay. Now I'm gonna publish this out. And when I publish this out, I'm gonna go ahead and load it back into Squirm Cloud. I'm going to upload it in Squirm Cloud and then we're gonna go through this course and I wanna show you how this gets sent over to the Learning Record Store and show you how you can send over these custom statements. Now, there's a lot more that you can add to the statements. You can add time and duration and variables and other information. Again, check out my course or my other videos on how to customize a lot of this stuff. I'm gonna go into my Squirm Cloud in preparation for this. And I'm gonna go ahead and delete my previous course because we're gonna upload a new version here. All right, so this is done publishing out. So make sure we zip it up here. And then let's go into Squirm Cloud and let's upload that zip file. So I'm going to go ahead and click on browse here, select that zipped file and hit upload. Go ahead and stretch out my browser here and click on import course. All right, so it's now imported. I can go ahead and click on launch here. And this is just to make sure that the data is getting over. If I want to go ahead and skip to that page, I'm going to click on my menu here and go down to my tab interaction and then minimize my menu and then click on tab one. Now it's sent over the XAPI statement, so to see it, I just close my course here, go back to my analytics and click on view registration statement history. And you can see right here, Jeff Batts interacted with sample text. And if I click on that, this is where I can provide additional text. I can provide additional metadata if I wanted to and add on to it. And that's usually, if you're providing additional metadata, it's usually in the form of what's called XAPI extensions. And there's a lot of additional capability that I can do to kind of expand this JSON data. Once that data is there, that's where something like Veracity or Watershed come into play, because then I could use that data, that JSON data, to create these reports and then create these shareable reports with stakeholders so they can see how much time people are spending in the course. Are they interacting with the tabs? Have they actually clicked on the tabs? That's the kind of information. So there's so much that you could do with XAPI here. And it boggles my mind that we're not exploring this even more. So there's a lot of potential here, a lot that you can do. And hopefully this opens up your mind a little bit of how to get started. There's a lot more that you can dive into. Like I mentioned, check out my additional videos on Storyline and XAPI, or you can also check out my full course in XAPI Fundamentals or full course in Storyline 360 on my website at learningdojo.ninja. If you like this video, head on over to my YouTube channel, click that like button and subscribe to my channel, as well as hit the bell notification so you get notified of all future videos as they come out. That really helps my channel, allows me to continue to produce these videos for you to help you with your e-learning developments and your Storyline skills as well. Also, if you want to learn anything else, if there's any other topic that you're interested in that you think I might be able to help, go ahead and leave a comment on my YouTube channel to say, hey, Jeff, I want to explore this, or what about this? What if we added this? I read all the comments. I'm open to additional suggestions of what you may have as well. But that's all I have for today. So thanks everyone, and I'll see you next time.